Hi, it's Heather and Joni with thecrazycouponlady.com, and today we are talking about where to find coupons for milk and how to save on milk in general.
All right, so according to the U.S. Department of Labor, the average price in October of 2012 for a gallon of whole milk was $3.52, which is the highest price we've actually seen since January.
Yeah, so it's tricky because most milk brands are regional. They don't have a lot of like national brands for milk.
Yes, it makes it tricky to save.
So it's tricky to save because they distribute coupons regionally instead of nationally.
And if that's not bad enough, did you know there's actually some states that prohibit like discounting or coupons for meat, including Colorado, Maine, Missouri, and North Dakota?
Interesting.
Glad I don't live in one of
those
spots.
Seriously.
But even with all of that, there are different ways that you can save on milk as well as find coupons for milk, and we're going to talk to you about that today.
Yeah, so let's talk first about where to find coupons for milk. So some of the sources that we found are places like realcaliforniamilk.com. Almost always on their website, they're going to have a coupon for
35 to 55 cents off like a dairy product. So you can use that on cheese or milk in California.
That's great. And then another one is hood.com. They'll have coupons for milk and all sorts of milk products. And then TrueMoo.com, this is a brand of chocolate milk. And we almost always have coupons for those as well. And then it's always great to look at coupons.com for milk. A lot of times we'll see brands like Silk and even some regional coupons. Like in Idaho and Utah, we have dollar off coupons for any brand of milk.
Yeah, so it's always going to be easier to find a coupon for one of these national brands or a different variety of milk, so chocolate milk or soy milk.
Yeah.
So look on Silk's website, Eight Continents website, Almond Breeze. Yeah. You're going to be able to routinely find coupons for those. You're also going to want to watch for coupons when you're in the store. There's often going to be coupons hanging on the dairy case or coupons that you can rip out of the store's weekly ad. And then one of my favorite ways to save on milk is actually by sometimes buying half gallons.
Yep.
My grocery store will often do, well, often, maybe once a month on a weekend, like a two-day sale, will do a 10 for 10 sale on half gallons of milk. So while the full gallon can cost me upwards of $3, I can sometimes get these for only a buck a piece. So that's when I, you know, buy a bunch of them.
Yeah, so another one of my favorite tips is to check your convenience store, like a gas station. Often they'll kind of put that as their loss leader to get you into the store. And the great thing is if all you need is a gallon of milk, you don't have to go to the very back of the grocery store.
Right.
And so typically their refrigerated cases are marked up 40%, but their milk is only marked up 10%.
So. And then some of them might reduce that to zero or even be willing to lose money just to lure you in the door.
Yep.
So just be aware of the convenience stores in your area. Another thing you want to be aware of is the date stamped on the milk. Remember that this is a best buy date. You know, it's not the date it came into the store. So you're looking for the date furthest in the future.
Yeah.
And at a place like a Walmart, it's not going to matter a whole lot. There's probably so much turnover that you're only going to see about a day of variance. But if you're using Heather's tip and visiting a convenience store where the turnover isn't as high, you're going to want to make sure that you're looking at the date so you're not going to get milk that's going to be bad.
And don't be afraid to like reach around the back and grab one towards the back.
We have no pride about that sort of thing.
So while we're talking about that, let's talk about kind of discounted milk. Sometimes at my grocery store, I'll see tags that are like marking the milk that's about to expire.
Right,
off.
If it's gonna, the best buy date is like 48 hours away or something.
Yeah. So look for that as well. And then if you are able to get a great sale on like the half gallons or something and you're able to stock up on milk, don't be afraid to stock up and just freeze it. A lot of people don't know that you can actually freeze milk.
So you have a process that works. Tell me a little bit about how you do that.
So the first thing is when you see milk and it's all the way full, that's gonna be a problem when you freeze it because it's going to expand. So you just open it up and you pour, I would say like a half a cup.
Yeah.
Out. And then put it back in, and you can put it in the freezer. That way, when it expands, it doesn't bulge. Another thing is when it's frozen, it's going to look a little bit yellowish, so you might worry. But once it thaws, it will, like, retain its color. It
so what totally about fine. When I have frozen milk, like, there's ice in it for forever, I feel like. How do you get it to thaw without being, like, clumpier?
The best way to let it thaw is just in the refrigerator for, like, 2 to 3 days.
Before you touch it.
You just have to give it enough time to let it freeze or thaw all the way. And then the other thing is you should just freeze it for up to 3 months, probably not much longer than
that.
3 months?
That's longer than I thought, though.
Yes, you actually can freeze it longer than that. It just will start, like, tasting like some of the other foods in your freezer, which is weird.
So depending on what you have.
Yes, exactly.
If you have a freezer full of Ben & Jerry's, it might be okay.
Yeah, seriously.
All right. So visit the Crazy Coupon Lady and subscribe to us on YouTube. We're going to be bringing you other tips about how to save on hard, you know, difficult to save on items.
Yep.
And we always will be sharing these deals. And come to our site and click print coupons. And you can use the search functionality to search for milk coupons. And you can be saving on milk in no time.